man says it is unreasonable to have a social structure of a bunch of neutered men acting as slaves for a woman. Outside of a modern city, of course, where it appears to be mandatory. They call them places offices. I will not sit in a cubicle like a veal calf while a woman shouts at me about making personal calls until I die. Caller, you are on the show. To whom am I speaking?
Hey there, Dwayne. The name's Charlie. Hope all's going well with your divorce.
No, Migo, it is in fact crappy as crappy could be. As I said, avoid lawyers at all costs. Now continue.
Well, yeah, my best friend died in a combine accident, and he left me a few head of cattle, but I ain't no farmer, so question is, how do I know if a female cow is in heat? They don't talk or nothing, they just move.
Oh, Charlie, that's simple. You have come to the right place, as I am an expert on estrus. What you gotta do is look for behavioral signs such as incessant mooing, but most of all, she will exhibit more vigorous interaction with other females, putting her chin on the rump of another cow and...
Oh yeah, yeah, keep going. Tell me about that dirty heifer.
God damn it. You are sitting there with a hot laptop on your sweaty thighs doing an image search for heifers, aren't you? Jesus. I'm tired of you sickos calling up and ruining my otherwise flawless broadcasting flow. This is a civilized show for civilized people, discussing a variety of topics relating and beyond insemination. Why, oh why, does this subject matter attract such a variety of perverts, creeps, and weirdos? It is quite beyond me. Now don't get me wrong, I mean, I like a good time. I've been known to participate in a pheromone party where you do not shave or bathe for 1 week and then partake in moonshine and speed with a group of other like-minded individuals in a hot tub. It is hell on the other side of that party, but it is worth the ride. But that does not mean I find calling up a radio program about royal affairs and pleasuring myself while perusing the heifer section of the information superhighway an acceptable form of behavior. Is that clear? Charlie, you pervert, is that clear?
Yes.
Are we straight, son?
Yes, sir.
Good. Now you take care, you hear?
Thank you, sir.
I am lost for words. Next caller.
Hi there, Dwayne.
Thank you. What brings you in today?
Thank you. fish?
Thank you.
to turn up. I want Apale by Rosalía.
Que mi mento me lo trilla.
people live too damn long, while the rich die young, having been worked to death paying for all these taxes. I've read the reports. They've tried to hide it.
I'm a strict constitutionalist myself. My grandma told me that when we were under the gold standard, you could buy a hamburger for a nickel. A nickel! Everything was clean. It just sounds better.
Well, I can tell you one thing from where I am right here in Bobby June's kitchen. This is how I see it. There's only one foreign policy that's 100% effective, and that's carpet bombing. Now, while this gator cooks, do you want to sing a song for us? I know you're known mostly for pop songs.
Yes, but I did some soul searching with my manager, accountant, and dialect coach, and they said that pop country would open a whole new world for me. So I've changed directions and politics a bit in order to explore this new demographic that doesn't save money and buys all kinds of superfluous stuff and doesn't have a clue what downloading is. This is a song from my new album. It's called I Like Things Just the Way They Are.